Well, joining me now is author Masande Ntshanga. He's here to talk about his book, The Reactive. And I'm going to tell you a bit more about it in just a moment. But he himself is a recipient of the Fulbright Award, the Mellon Mays Foundation Fellowship, and the Civitella Ranieri Fellowship. He's also won the 2013 Penn International New Voices Award. So I think the first question must be, what accolade have you not achieved? But a warm welcome to you. Thank you so much for joining us. Your book has been described as a poignant, life-affirming story about secrets, memory, chemical abuse, and family, and the redemption that comes from facing what haunts us the most. That sounds like a mouthful. What in the world inspired this book? Welcome.
Thank you for having me. I guess there are a couple of things. I was living in Cape Town at the time, and I was very interested in kind of writing about the city in the sense that it could be a place that could be interchangeable with any other global city, right? So I wanted it to be a very kind of modern and contemporary novel, exploring various themes like recreational drug use, terminal illness, and technology. But then the more I worked on it, the more I realized that it had to have a stronger engine, in the sense that if I wanted to write about South Africa, I would have to kind of work very hard in including South Africa.
Such a nuances.
Yes, are, yeah, yes. Local, yeah. And so I did the first draft, and it was kind of still lacking that engine. And then I went back, and I just started paying more attention to the environment that I was trying to write about. And then I think after that, I was able to kind of like write the first page almost in like one sitting.
Wow. Your work has been described, this particular one, in sentences which swing like nobody else's in the country. Masande Ntshanga sets out on a thrilling new expedition of writerly daring in The Reactive. Sounds impressive. Tell me about your particular style in this book.
Well, I guess I've always kind of had a relationship with language in which I was kind of very aware of its effects, and the last thing that I wanted to do in this book was kind of allow it to fall into cliche in such a way that if I was using kind of like received language, it would distract the reader and not make the experience as immersive as I wanted it to be. So I had to be very careful in how I used the language in the book, and also be kind of very, very deliberate in creating Lindanathi, the main character's voice. So I was actually quite pleased when I got that endorsement, because it was not incidental. It's something I worked really hard at.
Let's talk about what exactly you wanted to achieve in that hard work that you were putting in there. What was the objective? What did you want the reader to take out of this book?
Okay. I think primarily at the time, I really wanted to write the kind of book that someone could pick up, read from the front to the back, and walk away kind of feeling consoled, you know, feeling almost less alone simply from the reading experience. I think that was kind of like one of my primary objectives. And then the other was really to use the narrative to kind of explore certain questions I had about the country, you know. It's actually, not a lot of people pick up on it, but it's actually a period novel. It's based in 2003, just before antiretrovirals were available to the public. So I also chose that time as a way to parallel this kind of transition into adulthood that the characters were facing. And it was supposed to kind of, yeah, be paralleled with the transition that the country was facing, having gone from being liberated to again experiencing, almost for the first time, what it's like to kind of not necessarily be gelled, you know, with the new government.
And your work has been recognized locally, abroad, you name it. What has that done for you and suppose your self-confidence? Has it put a bit more pressure in your writings? I mean, are you sweating beads of blood there? Or has it affirmed you and given you, you know, the liberty to say, I'm going to go on and push more envelopes?
I think it's been more affirming than anything else. Yeah, I mean, it's been great. I went on a tour for the book in the United States, and just kind of like the reception that I got there was incredible. And I think, yeah, it has affirmed me, and it kind of also confirmed a suspicion that I had that, you know, you could write in such a way, even though a book is like very specifically South African, has a way of appealing to audiences mm-hmm. across the world. Mm-hmm. So that has kind of emboldened me also in kind of like the risks that I'm willing to take in the writing.
Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of people in the arts lament the fact that people will just wake up and just dabble in acting or singing, etc., and that will undermine the true singers or actors or writers in this case. A lot of people, I mean, I could wake up in the morning and decide, I'm going to write a book. Whether or not it will be any good is something else. What do you make of the industry at the moment? And is there still that respect for the craft and the attention to detail and the hard work that goes towards putting a book together?
Well, I think right now there are more alternatives available rather than the traditional model. A lot of people are self-publishing, for example, which I think there's definitely room for. I think given kind of like South Africa and the state of reading here, it doesn't hurt to have more authors and more books. But personally, I am kind of someone who still is very much tied to the editorial process mm-hmm. that goes with kind of like following, I suppose, a more traditional model.
Yeah.
Because you actually get a lot of help by people who've dedicated their lives to like literature. And I think that's very enriching for the author as well as for the reader in terms of, you know, the end product.
Mm. If I may be as tongue-in-cheek as my mind is taking me right now, what does the next chapter have in store for you? It's a bit cheesy, né? But let's go there. What are your future plans?
Well, right now, I'm going to be traveling to Amsterdam mm-hmm. for a festival that I'll be reading at there. And the UK version of the novel is also coming out, so I might also travel to London. But besides that, I'm currently like working on future projects.
Mm, so, more writing.
Yeah, like two novels.
Beautiful. Thank you very much. And you know where to debut them, ne? Right here. Don't you really have to go fast. Start here first and then you can go elsewhere. But congratulations
Thank
to you and well done and all the best for your future endeavors. The Reactive, it is available at Exclusive Books.
Yes.
Am I correct?
Yes.
Wonderful. Available at Exclusive Books. The Reactive there, Masande Ntshanga. Thank you very much for joining us. Here's
Thank
the book
you.
Cover there as well. And that's it for Book Club, at least for this week. Up next, a quick ad break.